Hey guys, my name is Jason. Today we're out here doing a little timber cruise. I've got 8 different sites. We're gonna go around measuring the DBH of the trees and taking the species, and then we're gonna do a bunch of calculations and figure out how many trees per acre I have in my ground. But right now I'm down in the stream buffer zone. I've got some really big alders here behind me, a bunch of little vine maple that don't count. This is the center of our circle. And so I'm gonna count and measure all the trees in this 10th of an acre plot and chart them all down on my notebook here. Let's look at some of the tools I'm gonna be using, and then I'll show you how to do this. I've already gone through a couple plots, so I'm on number 3, but on the first plot here on the left, I was doing the species, red alder and cottonwood were primarily what they were. I got the diameter breast height, and I've got if they're alive or dead. And those were in a 50th of an acre because the trees were so close together and they're all really small. Now that we're in this buffer zone, I'm doing a 10th of an acre, and the center of our plot is a red alder that's 21 inches diameter and it's still alive. And this guy is just right on the edge. It's a big old red alder. It's still alive. And a 10th of an acre plot is 37.2 feet in diameter. So I'm gonna come out here with my log tape. And this one's a special one because it's got length on one side, and on the other side it's got the diameter of the tree in inches. And so it's called a pie tape or a diameter tape. So I can take it, and using the diameter side of the tape, I wrap it around, and I come up with 24.5 inches DBH on this guy. That is a monster red alder. So there right behind me is our center tree, and over here, this guy is the one we just measured, and I'm down in the sandberries and the brush. And it's really hard to stretch a log tape from the center of your plot out 30, 40 feet through this brush. This guy is awesome. This is my new little friend here. So we've got our center tree. And what I started doing is going from the center tree and measuring out to each tree to see if it was 37 feet away. But then I quickly learned that you go to each tree, you turn it on, you measure back to the center tree, we're 31 feet, 11 inches away. And so you can just go to each tree, shoot it back to the center tree, center your plot, and you don't have to go back and forth. This thing is so cool. So now we got to go around. There's a big alder there, there, this guy. We're going to measure all these trees in this 37-foot radius, and then we can extrapolate in this buffer zone how many trees per acre we have. The other thing that's going on here in this buffer zone is these alders are big, mature, and the tops are starting to break out of them. That big one, the top broke out, and it's probably rotten right down through the middle. There's another one. I'm looking into the sun, so it's hard to tell. There's a little snag. The whole top blew out of it, and now it's a dead snag. There's another one. And so the whole buffer zone in here is right at maturity. They're starting to die off, and there's no evergreens in here at all coming up to shade out these little creeks that are all salmon streams full of aquatic critters. And so one of my big projects here is to brush out a bunch of this underbrush, the salmonberry and this vine maple, plant a bunch of spruce, cedar, and get some more evergreens coming up in this buffer zone. Leave the alders, they're doing their thing. They'll rot out, die, be snags, good habitat, but we want to get something coming up underneath to really get this little stream shaded out. You can see in the past there's a huge cedar stump right here. So it was good habitat. I've seen several of those big stumps around. That's the plan, and that's why we're doing this, is we're trying to figure out kind of the different zones. This was logged about 30 years ago, and you can see back over there outside of this buffer zone, it's just dog hair, alder, and cottonwood. All right, I wanted to show you I'm done with my plot number 3. It was all red alders except for one little cascara that was only 4.5 inches in diameter. They're all pretty big, you can see here, but there's 12 red alders. I'm not going to count the cascara. There's 12 red alders in this 10th of an acre plot right here. So when I multiply 12 by 10, that's 120 trees per acre in this buffer zone. So that's what 120 trees per acre looks like. Again, I'm not including the vine maple and all the brush. But if you look across there out of the buffer zone, and I'll show you, I'll do a a little closer look here in a minute. But right over there where they logged and they didn't replant and it's all alder and cottonwood, I got 37 trees in a 50th of an acre. And I think I did the math and it came out to 1,850 trees an acre. So it's just dog hair thick over there. Whereas all this stuff behind me, the big trees are all that's left. All the young ones have died out, or these are the ones that competed and won. And so it's just real open space, a lot of brush now, and they're all dying. So we gotta get them replaced with some evergreens coming up underneath them here in the next couple of years. Well, we're at sample site number 4 here. I think that's backwards, I don't think you can read that, but this is a little bit more characteristic of what it looks like when it was logged. The spot over closer to the road, the first couple sample sites were thicker than this. We're still gonna do a 50th of an acre plot. There just won't be so many trees. And these trees are actually a little bit bigger than what I was measuring earlier. These are gonna be 6, 8, maybe even 10 inch diameter trees. But let me get this site measured. 50th of an acre plot is 16 feet, 6 inches or something. All right, here's site number 4. I got a bunch of red alder and a cottonwood at the bottom. They're all kind of between 5 and 7 inches, I think, is the biggest one. The cottonwood is 9, so it's a little bit bigger, but those are quite a bit bigger than the plot number 2. I'll show you that in a second. There's 12 trees here on a 50 acre plot, a 50th of an acre plot. That's 600 trees per acre. And then here's plot number 2. You're getting 4.5, 2.5, 4.5, 1.5, 1.5, 4, 4, 3. They're a lot smaller, and there's 37 trees in that 50th of a plot. So these are either competing a lot more with each other and they're not growing as big, or this side over here, this number 4, they have already competed out the smaller ones. They've grown up and they're maybe a little bit older. I'm not quite sure. They should all be about the same age. Maybe this is a better site. Maybe this wasn't seeded as heavy as site number 2, but it's really interesting to see the difference once you get all these trees plotted. All right, guys, now we're on sample site number 6, and this is on the far western side of the property. We've crossed over a little creek, and so I don't think this was logged in the last maybe 100 years. It was probably logged, clear cut, and they took all these big cedars. There's big cedar stumps all over this property, and they probably logged that about 100 years ago, and then the property was logged again about 25 years ago and then reprotted with alder, natural reseed, and that's what I've been measuring. They couldn't cut along the stream buffers, and that's why you have these great big alders left over. But now we're on this western kind of edge, and we're back in this huge evergreen forest, big cedars. That one, these are all second growth, but they're really, really nice looking trees. I mean, they go up for a ways. This is what I would love to have this property get back to. I will never see it in my lifetime, but my two little kids, if they can come out and help me plant trees, and maybe over 60, 70 years, they can see it kind of start to resemble what we're standing in now. But I'm gonna do a 10th of an acre plot here because they're big trees and pretty far apart, and it's pretty well stocked. I don't see any fir. There's hemlock and there's cedar, and there's a few straggling alders and birch. This is one of those massive western red cedars we have in our plot. This thing is really big, and I got to get above the butt swell. I don't want to get into that butt swell in there, so I'm going to go a little bit higher than DBH, just because these older cedars, they swell out at the butt. Oh man, that's a big tree. 45. That's a 45 DBH cedar tree. That's a monster. Also, be careful when you're pulling on this tape. I was pulling on this tape one time and it sliced my hand open. So wear gloves or don't pull on the tape. Well, sample site number 5 has 11 evergreens and 5 deciduous trees, paper, birch, and alder, which ends up being about 170 trees per acre at a 10th acre plot. And that is a really nice stocking level for a mature evergreen forest here in the next 20, 30, 40 years. Those deciduous trees are gonna die out and fall over. You're gonna have these smaller hemlocks and I actually got a spruce in this plot. So those are gonna come up and you're gonna have this really nice, big, mature evergreen forest that has 100, 120 trees per acre. Oh, it's just gonna be perfect. I just finished up with sample site number 7 and that's it for this property. It's 20 acres total and I've got a lot more work to do. I'm really, really stoked about this new property. So stay tuned for a lot more videos of this. I've also got my logging stuff going on down on my other 50 acre property. So lots more to come, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something. Thanks for watching and we'll see you on the next one.